Well, I'd just like to teach y'all a little bit before you go, because I figured if where two or more are gathered, there you all should learn something. And I thought I'd teach you a little bit on how to speak Southern. Anybody north of the Mason-Dixon line here tonight? Do you know what the Mason-Dixon line is? No. I didn't think so. Well, now, if you ain't from the South, then you're probably north of the Mason-Dixon line. A lot of y'all have trouble understanding us Southerners. You say, what does he mean? You know what the plural of y'all is? Anybody know what the plural of y'all is? Yes. All y'all. That's right. I'm telling you. Anyway, I come up with some words of my own here, and I figured they ought to learn you how to speak Southern. And if you know how to speak Southern, then you can just about go anywhere in the South then. Here's a word. You ready? One, two, three. Sinner. That's where all them women go on Saturdays, to them shopping centers. Oh, this is a great Southern word. I'm fixing to dig me some worms and go fishing. Now, if you got a long ways to go, then it's probably a... Furby. It ain't no animal you wear around your neck, ladies. Ready? When dancing came to...
Georgia!
They say the best thing to come out of Georgia? I-75. Oh. That's where you go get you some of that crayfish pie and jambalaya down in... Yawlins. It's a two-syllable word. Yawlins. Yawlins. Ready? One, two, three.
Yawlins.
Ooh, y'all Southern already. Ready? One, two, three.
Wretched.
That's Elizabeth Taylor's first husband, Wretched Burton. Nice night tonight, isn't it? Exactly what you mean by that one. Or you can say it in the negative. I don't know exactly what you mean by that. It works both ways. This is always plural, and it's a two-syllable word. Now, if you as a northerner, I was over at the breakfast shop the other day, and I heard a northerner say, "You know, I think I'm going to try me one of those grits." I say, "Lady, you're going to be hungry." It's grits. Grits. Or you can say Georgia ice cream. Now, there's more of these than there are people. Baptist. One, two, three.
Wrench.
Wrench that dish rag out and wipe that youngin's nose. One thing I can't stand is nastiness. That girl don't care nothing for him. I wouldn't go out with him. He don't care for you. Do you know what I'm talking about? Do you know what I mean? That's where you go. I don't go to these as much as I used to. To the Baba. Some of you don't know. This ain't a toupee. This is the real stuff. I know a lot of you thought that was a toupee I was wearing. You know, a fake bald head, you know, like Telly Savalas. It's real. My wife gives me chrome polish for my birthday. They say if you go bald here, you're a thinker. If you go bald here, you're a lover. My wife says if you go bald here and here, you just think you're a lover. I don't care nothing for that. I found a scripture in the Bible for baldness, though.
Preach it.
Thank you. Leviticus 13:40 says the man who has lost his hair, he is bald, yet he is clean. Who wants to be clean before the Lord? Come on, get your head checked. I like signs too. You ever been driving down the highway? Like, see a bunch of. You getting blessed, sister? Speak it, speak it. Somebody give the interpretation. I'm driving down the highway. My favorite sign of. Not my favorite sign, but. One, you know, what? Who says there's not truth in advertising? I saw a Stucky sign. It says, "Eat here, get gas." Yeah. Guess where I ate? Well, the sign said, "Exit now." What if we took those literal? Exit now. Or slow children playing. My favorite sign of all. My favorite sign of all. And will always be a Shoney's sign. I was driving down the road, looked over to the right, because that's where the sign was. It said, Shoney's Restaurant, you know. Then over in the right-hand corner, it said, "We have menus in Braille."
Excuse me, but I happened to read your sign. Notice that you have menus in Braille. Of course, the road bumps were quite severe coming over.
Hallelujah!
I want to go there.